Okay, guys. So, this is going to be the first gameplay video of the How to Play Solo series. I'm on Amaterasu because she has a harder time laning, so I feel like it would be more valuable if I did a tutorial or somewhat of a general guide on how to play Ama, because she does have a very hard time in solo. So, this game, it looks like I'm probably against Chang'e. So, I guess against Chang'e, what you want to do is you want to wait for her to use her, what are they called? Crescent Moon and Moonlit Waltz, I think? Is that what they're called? I don't know. Something like that. But you want to wait for her to use her two clear abilities, and then you want to clear the wave. She won't clear the wave with the two abilities, even with full Soul Stone and Purple Pot. That's just Chang'e. Like, she doesn't really have good clear. She also doesn't really heal well. I don't know. Chang'e's not that good. She's the only viable mage healer right now, and she's not even very viable at all. Like, she's okay, probably around a B tier. So you're looking at situational, but even then, not very good. So Susan and I are just clearing these buff camps here. This is just the general start for solo. If you don't know, you know, you just go speed to blue. There's a few variations. You can start mid camps, blue. You can go mid camps, speed, then blue buff. You can start what's it called? You can start that, or you can go straight to what's it called? The fire imps right after speed buff, or mids. You can do a lot of different. All right, that's a good start. You can do a lot of different stuff in solo. Hey, that was really good. So what went wrong there for him was he went in 1v2 against a really strong early game god like what's his name, like Susano, and I was also there supporting him. So he had the help from my damage, as well as the absolute disgusting damage of Susano early game. So that guy fucked up. That's just plain and simple. That guy fucked up. So, Chang'e, she has Soul Stone. She probably just sent her bunny back so she can buy what's it called? What's the other magical start item? Vampiric Shroud. Because that's just what Chang'e does, because she needs the extra magical power to help her clear. So yeah. For Chang'e, this is one of the things you do. I mean, chances are you'll out-clear her, so you really just want to abuse that and sort of push her out of lane if you have the chance to. So you can see I've already got her down to 250 health. Each tick is 100 health, if you didn't know that. So, kind of poked her out of lane a little bit. You can see, like, she's kind of done. So, if you ever face against a mage solo, that's basically what you want to do. As soon as you can start out-clearing them, because chances are they'll out-clear you at level 1 if you're playing someone like Ama. But that's what you want to do. Pressure them out of lane, get that early lead, abuse that lead. And that's what I'm going to try to show you guys here. It's going to be a little bit difficult because Chang'e only gets stronger as the game goes on. She's not early game based at all. She's a very late game goddess. But I should be able to abuse my lead. One of the reasons that warriors are played in solo is because of their potential to abuse a lead. If a solo laner gets very far ahead, they will stay very far ahead if they know how to play. That's just a fact. That's how solo lane is. So, that's what I'll be trying to do here. It's not always easy, because sometimes they'll play very safely, sometimes they'll play very aggressively, and sometimes they can make up for their early game losses with, you know, the use of, like, a jungler. So here you can see I'm trying to just zone her out of farming. Basically pushing the minions under their tower, because whenever a minion gets hit from the tower, not when they're targeted, but when they get hit by the tower, they will no longer give gold. Even if you last hit them, they will no longer give any gold. You get XP, but you do not get gold. So that's one of the reasons why I'm pushing them under the tower. That's what people do, that's why it's so effective. So, right now I'm looking to steal her blue buff, because we have no eyes on their jungler. It looks like she's coming around here to try and secure it. She ulted for that, which was a big mistake, because she also used her 2, which means I will now kill her with my ultimate. Easy. So, what went wrong for her there? She blew her two escape abilities, or two CC immunity abilities, that she could have used to help her get away, her ultimate, to secure her blue buff, as well as her two, which makes her invulnerable, and CC immune. So that way she had all of her CC immunity down, I could ult her, finish off the kill that way. Is he gonna do speed? Alright, whatever. Anyways, so that way I could finish her off using my ultimate, secure the kill. I did not get blue buff, but that's okay because she picked it up anyways and died with it. So even if she had teleport, which, yeah, she does, but it was down, I believe. So even if she had teleported back to lane, she wouldn't be able to pick it back up because she was dead. That's an example of abusing the lead. That's one of the best ways that you can abuse the lead is by stealing away their buff. Another way is just by killing them. And then the simplest, easiest, most surefire way of abusing a lead is these fire imps, elemental things, whatever you want to call them. I've called them fucking fire harpies before. I don't know, whatever. Whatever you want to call them, those are really good. Those give you 90 gold for clearing the camp. Doesn't seem like much, but when you add it or when you pick it up in the beginning of the game, that can get you boots an entire wave earlier. It's just, it adds up, I guess is what I'm trying to say. Is that it's not good on its own, but it adds up. It also gives you an XP lead, which is very good. So, since I'm against a magical god, I'm going to be getting Genji's guard. If I was against a physical god, like a warrior or a hunter, I would be getting either Breastplate of Valor, or I would be picking up Hide of the Nemean Lion if they were an ADC. However, because she is Chang'e, a magical god, I'm picking up Genji's Guard for the CDR, the protections, and the CCR. I think it's CCR. So here you can just see I'm just pressuring her under her tower. I'm not really worried about dying here. I mean, she already blew her ultimate and it really didn't do that much to me. So I'm not too worried about dying. Does Genji just provide CCR? No, I'm thinking of Oni. But whatever. Doesn't matter. So, right here. Oh, just kidding. I didn't even see him. I was about to say right here I'm looking to pressure her out. But looks like my team wants to gank. So we're going to try to kill the Susano. Which might be a bit of a mistake, just because he's very mobile. Because we've also got Fafnir on the side. Doesn't look like we're going to get anything off this except for a little bit of lane pressure. And if you're a jungler, you gotta remember, lane pressure, if you don't get a kill off a gank, that's okay. Pressuring a lane is just as helpful, believe it or not. Because a lot of times, if you can pressure a lane hard enough, they'll back. So, it's helpful. What the fuck? Alright. I don't know what he's doing. He's going fucking hard, though. Gonna start backing off here because I really don't want to fight this. 3v2 and I have no mana. And no health. Really not looking to fight this. But it looks like they're backing off. I'm gonna basically stack my 2 off of the big minion because if I push up, I'm afraid that Chang'e will ult me and kill me. I don't have the cooldowns for Chang'e memorized, so better not take the risk. Alright, so finished up Genji's guard here. What that'll do is that'll give me a lot more protections against Chang'e. I'll be a lot beefier, as well as I'll be able to dish out more damage because I'll have CDR, and if she hits me with any of her abilities or basic attacks, I will get 2 seconds off all of my cooldowns. Very, very, very good. So here I'm just clearing up my blue. I'm gonna pick that up before she even gets a chance to steal it. Head back to lane. So you saw I got XP for that minion, but I did not get any gold. That's what I was talking about earlier, when towers take away gold. You gotta remember that. Tower, if you have to, you can let minions into your tower. But if you don't have to, try to avoid it as much as possible, just because you lose a lot of gold. Minions are like your main source of gold, so they're very important. So, you see, just by abusing this lead, I'm now 3 levels ahead of Chang'e. That's a huge lead. If you want to check gold, you can see I'm over 1,000 gold ahead of her. Now she's rotating the team fights, and I should have been with her, but whatever. That's my bad. Another thing you have to remember is that you need to rotate with the other solo laner. Once you're, you know, a little bit more experienced, you can kind of gauge yourself when you should be rotating. But if you're newer, as a rule of thumb, just rotate when your other laner rotates. I can't get that kill. I'm just gonna back out. Just gonna try to push her out. Do a little bit of damage. Do whatever damage I can. I'm gonna ping her for Susan, because it looks like he wants to go around the back end and kill her. I can't help him. Oh, okay, I just made a huge mistake there. Yeah. Artemis called missing left. I should have backed off. Might be. Okay, we're gonna pick up. Most likely. It's okay, we already have meditation, we already have curse, so I'm probably gonna pick up a shell. Enemies have returned to base. Judging off of their team comp, a shell wouldn't be bad. Because it reduces damage taken by 15%. The protections, the 45 magical and physical protections, are very good in the early game, but late game they're not that great. But that's why you get it for the 15% damage taken reduction. The shell is really good, but I think meditation and curse kind of take precedence over shell, in my opinion. Be right back. And if you're playing solo lane, if you're playing like a warrior or a guardian, you really don't want to get like beads or Aegis or sanctuary. Sanctuary or purification, there we go, whatever. You don't want to get those because you're a tanky warrior, you don't need it. You're gonna survive any damage that they throw at you, really. So you can forget about those, you're gonna be wanting to build your utility relics, right? One of those will almost always be teleport. You'll see every time I play solo I always have teleport. Super useful. Super, super useful. So here we're just trying to steal out her blue buff. I don't know why, but he wanted to ult it. Oh, this is a bad idea. Yeah, I don't know if I can really help him here. I can't. Yeah, no, he's gotta get out. We're all good here. If they come under the tower, I can try to, I can ult them and fight. But otherwise, I don't really want to look for a fight here. There's no point for me in looking for a fight. My team is looking for a fight over here. I don't know why, but they're looking for it. I'm gonna try to finish off Susano. Okay, now we're gonna try to get out. Pop shell. Just for the team. Well, for me and Kumba. Oh, he had meditation. No need. I'm going Fafnir here. Just try to pressure him out. Get him to fuck out of my lane. Come on, Giannis. Do things. Ooh. Giannis did things. Oh, there we go. There we go. Let's get her. Let's get her. She has no mana. Ugh. Everything is down. Team should have gone in. So I'm going to clear out my blue buff here because there's no way that I can really contest that fight. My heal isn't very powerful right now. Just because I don't have the protections really to complement it. I can't really tank a tower because I don't have a breastplate. Oni's doesn't give me any health. The only health I have is 100 health, and that's from Cudgel. So it's not that good. So I can't really tank the tower for very long. I also can't really soak up that much damage, and for some reason we keep fighting in solo. I'm just here to farm. Oh, I fucked that. Oh, never mind. I did get the silence. Okay. Yeah, I'm just here to farm. I don't want to fight. I do not want to fight. I don't want to try to get kills. But I did get kills, so this is very good. So far this game looks like it's going pretty well. It's 12-7. We're a little bit behind. Probably did he just teleport to my oh my god. Oh my gosh. An assassin with teleport and curse, that's a little risky. Hopefully it'll work out though. I don't know. You'll see weird shit. Sometimes it'll work. Most of the time it won't. A beacon. Yeah, it looks like I'm getting ganked. It's a good thing I put that ward there. Wards are also super important. They don't have to be sentries. I just put a sentry there because that's what I had. But if you have a ward, or if you have the money after you back, always try to get two wards. Two wards almost always. Very, very good. Wards will keep you alive. Wards will keep your team alive, because if you forget to call a missing, or if you just don't want to or whatever, they'll see the missing. There you go. Alright, now we're just going to pressure this tower a little bit. Oh, she ulted me. She really thinks she can kill me. She's still three levels behind. I don't think she realizes that. She doesn't have any pen either.
We got one, guys!
Just gonna keep pressuring out this lane. Just gonna keep showing her this is my fucking lane. This is not your lane, Chang'e. As much as you wish it was, it's not. Oof. She immune to that. Alright, we're gonna deward here. That way, if my team wants to gank, they can.
Did you do that all by yourself?
Alright, so tell me what you guys think of these videos, right? Tell me what you want, if you want anything more or less out of these videos. Because I'm very new to YouTube, I'm very new to kind of this whole teaching the game to someone else. I'm liking it though. I'm definitely liking it. I got a lot of positive feedback on the first two videos of the tier list and the general sort of build guides. So I figured, you know, why not do some gameplay videos? You know, because that's one of the best ways to learn, is just through watching someone else play and seeing what they do, in my opinion, at least. Alright, so we're going to be teleporting back to lane. Like I said, we're going to be getting a ward. Since we already have a ward up high. I'm not really leveling my skills in any particular order. After your 2 and your 1, you can really do either your 3 or your ultimate. Doesn't really matter. All it does is increase the damage for both, so it's not like it's a huge... Oh, she just lagged out of that. It's not like it's a huge difference on whatever you get. Okay, so she just fucked up there. She's gonna immune the stun here, but that's okay. Oh, it's not okay. I need to pop shell. Yeah, they're coming right. Oh, they just Yana assaulted. It's actually a really good timing that I got out the time that I did. I did not realize that Yana was ulting. I don't know why, but they really want this Chang'e to be incredibly far ahead. And I don't see it happening. Oh, I'm dead. Oh, just kidding. Oh no, I'm dead. I'm so dead. Alright. This is totally gonna work. It's totally gonna work. Oh my god. That was too risky. Oh my gosh. Okay. I was not proxy farming there, but that shows you what the risks of proxy farming are, because their team can completely, like, just go around you and sort of sandwich you in. So, what if you don't know, proxy farming is standing in between this tower and this tower, and farming here. You can also proxy farm there, 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 there. You can proxy farm anywhere that you're in between two towers. It's really good because it gives you space and allows you to get pressure onto a tower. But it's really risky because their enemy team can rotate on you and you really won't have somewhere to go. I'm just gonna get this tower because it's annoying me.
There was nothing you could have done there.
I'm gonna go help out the team with this Fafnir. Switching to power aura just to help them out with the damage. We've got Ho-Yi jumping in. Trying to focus down the Ho-Yi because that's all their damage and that's what you want to do. I'm switching to my other aura for the healing, and there we go. We need to get out now. I'm going to be calling for the retreat just because Yannis just ulted. Oh, both Yannis is ulted. So I'm calling for the retreat. Looks like most of the team listened except for Yannis, which is really good. Yannis hit her. Oh my gosh, that's funny. So So, if you see, I already have 30% CDR plus 2 seconds off whenever I take magic damage. That's really good. Really, really important. I'm probably going to find another 10% of CDR through Spirit Robe. Maybe not. I don't know. Maybe Jotuns, I might overcap on CDR by 10%. But either way, CDR is very good on Amaterasu. It's one of your core things. Your core things on Ama are like a little bit of attack speed through maybe like a Winged Blade or Chin Size if you're ahead. You can also get stuff like, hold on. That's pretty much what you're going to get for attack speed. You want Power and you want Pen, so you want your Jotuns, Titans, stuff like that. On Ama though, the reason that you want attack speed is because of her passive. If you don't know her passive, what it does, I'll press K. You can pause it to read it. Basically what it does is after 3 basic attacks, the enemy it will create an aura around that one enemy that you got 3 basics on. And basically what it'll do is that anyone in that aura will take 10% more damage from all sources. So not just from you, but from everyone on your team. That's too bad. Let's see if I can get this Giannis. Damn. Whatever. He probably has a lot of CDR. Yeah, he's got Kronos. And we're gonna go help the team out. I got a little bit out of position there. Okay. I don't think I'll be able to save that tier 1 over in right. Yeah, no, but it's not really a huge deal. The solo lane tier 1 is the least important tower objective on the map. So if you have to sacrifice any tower, sacrifice the solo tower. As long as it's the T1. We're going to call it enemy missing. Alright, there we go. I'm going to be backing soon because I've got 1200 gold, so I could get a tier 2 of something. Probably gonna be Genjis, or not Genjis, Chins. Maybe Titans, I don't know. I'm still really far ahead, so I want more damage, so I don't know. I'm thinking Titans right now, but we'll see. I'm gonna steal away her blue. So you can see that because of the way. What the hell? Alright. I don't know why she keeps ulting her blue buff. She really wants it, but because the way I was able to keep my lead and abuse the early game lead and pressure that I had, I'm still 3 levels ahead of her, even 22 minutes into the game. So she's level 16 with most of the rest of her team. She's even behind their ADC, and that's really not what you want on a solo laner. Solo laners pretty much go even or win lane, because that way they get all that solo farm and they are levels, they're miles ahead of your team and the enemy team in gold and XP. That's kind of the job of a solo laner. You get very far ahead just from XP and you don't lose lane. That's one of the many jobs that you'll be performing in solo. I did my job, so we're kind of stomping the enemy team, because I have that huge lead, so I can provide that really high damage. I can provide the silence, the stun, all that kind of stuff. Alma's a very good team fight god, and if I'm here very far ahead like I am, able to fulfill that role that Alma fills, it's very good for my team. Very, very good, very helpful. So it looks like we're looking to engage here. Yeah, Kumba's looking to engage. I'm gonna try to ult. I didn't hit the second hit because I targeted the Hoagie, and the Hoagie just jumped out, so that's too bad. I'm popping Shell right now because of the Hoagie ultimate, and we need to help Kumba. I'm switching auras for the healing. I'm going on Fafnir because he could fuck my team up. It's a good thing we killed him quickly. I'm gonna try to kill this Chang'e. Yeah, she's at that part in the game where she'll start to do a lot of damage, so we really don't want to let her do that damage in fights. So soon we're going to have to start focusing Chang'e down in fights, but because of how far behind she is, because of the way that I abuse my lead, she's reaching that late game powerful god that she is much later than she should be. She should have been about this powerful maybe 5-6 minutes ago. I'm probably gonna die here. It's not on my team with me. Yeah. That was my bad. Okay. So, I think I could go with more damage here. But I might want to go with anti-healing, just because of the way that Chang'e can heal her whole team. But at the same time, I don't really have a lot of AoE abilities that will proc anti-healing. So I don't really want to get this. So I'm thinking maybe Chen's. I think that's what I'll get, because that'll synergize well with Titans. Warriors are really nice, because if you're ahead, you can build more damage, and if you're behind, you just build more defense, and you'll survive. So, that's a really good thing about Warriors. That's one of the things that I like, is because their builds are just so flexible. Like, Mages and Hunters have pretty static builds for the most part. It's all about optimizing damage. But with Warriors, it's more versatile in my opinion. I like it. Alright, so we need to go help out with this team fight because my team's getting a little bit fucked on. So I gotta try to help them defend this tier 2. Tier 2 towers give the enemy team a lot of gold, and we really don't want to let them have that. So I'm just here to try to save the tower, help my team push the wave out, maybe even pressure out this Giannis because he's being an asshole. Ah! Almost had him. It looks like Susano might catch up. No. Nah. Whatever. It was close. I did a lot of damage to him just because of the way that Titans works with my abilities. Did so much damage. Okay, Hoyi's backing. We're just gonna take this tower quickly. Gonna do that so we can get minions soon. Yeah. We don't really need minions. The reason why you would want minions in sieging a tower is because minions remove backdoor protections, which basically makes you do 50% less damage to a tower. So if you've got minions, or if you've got like Bastet Cats, or if you've got Bakasura ultimate minions, basically you'll do 50% more damage to the tower than you would without any minions. Try to ult this Giannis. There we go. I have to back off because I'm losing health. I'm probably going to back and teleport back to right lane because Susano's split pushing and I cannot let that happen. So you can see he backed off really quickly. So if you do that and you notice that every time that you teleport they instantly back off without seeing how much health you're on, you can do one thing that's really cheeky. It's risky, but you can teleport on like no health in the middle of a team fight, and if he doesn't know that you have low health, he'll back off instantly. I've done that a few times in like ranked games, even in Challenger Cup I've done that a couple of times. It's very helpful, it's a really good way to get someone off your ass, and it's relatively safe. Relatively. Not very, but relatively. So, we won that game due to them surrendering because of the immense lead that we created in the solo lane, as well as them basically having one tank, and that's Fafnir, and he was also pretty far behind. So, builds. We're gonna go over everyone's builds, because every new player has a problem with building. You're overwhelmed because there's so many items. What the fuck is that noise? Whatever. I think it's my dad working on something. So, Kumbakarna. Kumbakarna went for the standard support build. He got, Watcher's Gift into Traveler's Shoes, into Breastplate of Valor for the CDR, Bulwark Sovereignty. This is a very good build. This is a very solid build. This is what you want to be holding on support almost every time. Almost. Traveler Shoes and Watcher's Gift. These items will give you so much gold that you'll pretty much stay even with your team. Here he didn't, just because our team was so far ahead and we were getting a lot more kills than he was, and he wasn't really solo farming, he was rotating, helping us get kills, so he was a little bit behind in gold. But he would have been so much more behind if he went, say, cooldown boots and Mark of the Vanguard. My build. This is a build that you want to be running in solo pretty often if you're against a magical god like Chang'e. Genji's Guard is the item that you want if you're against a magical god. You don't want to get Bulwark because Bulwark's too expensive, and it doesn't really give enough protections and doesn't give CDR. Genji's gives CDR, and it also gives cooldown reduction through the passive, so that's something very valuable on most warriors. Frostbound Hammer. Frostbound Hammer works incredibly well with gods like Amaterasu and Bellona. Just because it lets you stick to people, it slows them down, helps your team kill them, and also gives you a little bit of power and a lot of health. Breastplate of Valor, core on almost every warrior. Actually, core on every single warrior, I think. Pretty much core. You really need Breastplate of Valor because it has 300 mana, 75 magical or 75 physical protection, and 20% cooldown reduction. That allows you to stay in teamfights longer. It also allows you to do more damage because you're staying in these teamfights longer because you have the CDR and because you have the protections and the mana. Breastplate of Valor is very, very good. Titan's Bane, because I was smashing, as you can see, I was doing incredibly well, I was very far ahead, you can see I had 2,000 more gold than anyone on my team except for Susano, and he was 10-4. So that's why I went Titan's Bane, to complement my damage, and to keep pressuring that lead, and keep pushing the enemy further and further behind, because it gives physical power, and 33% physical penetration, which is very good. Chin Size allows me to stack my passive quicker. Chin Size is also very in the meta right now. That's what you want to be building on these basic attack gods, except for, like, Bellona. Artemis. Artemis didn't go for a very good build. Artemis's build is all over the place. She started with Golden Bow. That's what you want to do on every single hunter, but Transcendence is no longer meta for hunters. It is not good for hunters anymore. It's good for some warriors, it's good for some assassins, as you can see on Susano, but it's not very good on hunters. It used to be must-buy every time, but it has fallen off since then, and it's not good anymore. She started building into Wind Demon. Wind Demon is very good, but you see she had no attack speed to complement it. She had no attack speed, she had no lifesteal. What you want to be building on a hunter is not this. You want to get Golden Bow. The main build is Golden Bow, Warrior Tabi, Ikaval, Aussie, and then you can get Chin Size, Titans. You can also get stuff, like if you go the Snoopy build, you can go Golden Bow, you would get Fatalis, then you get Devo Gloves, then I think it's Ikaval, Wind Demon, Deathbringer, then you sell Ikaval for Titan's Bane. So that's one of the ADC builds that you're wanting to run. But not something like this. This build is like four builds in one, right? It's all over the place. Yannis. Yannis's build is very good. However, Yannis has no CDR, and Yannis is a god that really benefits from CDR, probably out of any other mage. Yannis is a very unsafe god without CDR. Because in teamfights, if you use your 1 and your 2 to combo someone and kill them, you have no escape for a very long time. So if you look at his utility stat, he had 0% CDR. Not good. However, Book of Thoth is an incredibly high magical power item because of the passive and because of the raw 100 magical power. Obsidian Shard, 33% penetration and 70 power. Very good. Pen Boots, also very good. Very good build coming out of Yannis, however, it would have done better with some CDR. Like a Kronos Pendant, either before Book of Thoth or after Book of Thoth. Susano. Susano had a pretty good build. I like this build on Susano because it has half damage, half defense. But if I were him, I would have placed Transcendence before Jotun's, because Jotun's has Pen, and you don't really need that Pen until later on, and Transcendence will give you a lot more power than Jotun's will, because of the passive. He also went for Curse and Teleport, which is an incredibly risky thing that I do not advise for newer players. If you get Beads and Aegis on a squishy jungler like Susano, it's very helpful because otherwise you'll get focused down. Their Susano had a very good build as well. I like this build a little bit more than our Susano's, just because it has a lot more damage in it. However, you can see he didn't do very well. I don't know if that was because of his build or because of the way he's playing. I didn't really see him that much. Their Yannis had the build that I was thinking of. Right, where you get the Kronos Pendant early on. Chang'e had a good build despite her being very far behind. That's exactly what you want to be building on Chang'e. You get the double starters. Cooldown boots, Breastplate of Valor. She already had 30% CDR by the time she finished Breastplate of Valor. She also had Book of Thoth. But by the time that she got Book of Thoth, I had finished Genji's and I had started Frostbound Hammer. So I was already very healthy and very safe. So this Book of Thoth wasn't very value for her until she started getting Pen, but the game had ended too early. Hoagie. Hoagie had a pretty good build. This is what you want to be building, generally. However, he had no Ichabod, and he went Rage, or he went for the crit build when we had a very tanky team. We had three gods that were building physical protections. You don't really want to go crit unless you have a squishy solo, hunter, mage, and jungler. If the only tank on the enemy team is their support, that's when you want to build crit. Because crit does not do very well against tanks. Fafnir. He had a pretty good build. That's also one of the standard support builds. Support builds are pretty much just get tanky. It's pretty good. He fell behind in gold a little bit because he didn't have those Talaria or Traveler shoes. What are these? These are Talaria. No, these are Traveler shoes. Talaria, the physical equivalent of those. But that's builds. Here are your stats if you want to see. Anyways, thank you guys for watching. If you made it this far, remember to like the video, comment, and subscribe. I will reply to every single comment. And if you subscribe, thank you very much. I'll see you guys next time. Peace out.